Hey guys, what's up? It's Sean, Autotopia LA, and I'm here with my buddy, my little brother, Steven from SMP Fab. Steven's been on the channel before with his Bandito truck that he built for a client. But today, we're getting into Steven's personal car.
Something way different.
Way different. So what year is it?
This is an 86 325 IS BMW, also known this body style as an E30.
Right. So it was a clean car when you got it?
Clean car.
Like not rusted or anything?
No, this was like the cleanest car I found. I honestly one day said, I'm sick of having trucks. I have a bunch. I kind of want to build a car. I can't really afford anything expensive, but I also don't want something really cheap.
Right.
And you can't really go wrong with German engineering.
Now, I know you didn't leave this stock beyond the obvious stuff.
So it's a factory 2.7 liter.
Right.
This is a 325 IS, so it has a little bit bigger motor. So the motor is actually the original motor liter. I blew the other one up. You know, so I said, I'm not putting something with the same power back in, but I wanted to keep it original. I didn't want to do the S52 swap and like a newer BMW motor. I wanted to keep it OG. This was an OG car that was super clean. I want to keep it that way. So I ended up doing higher compression motor, forged pistons, forged cranks, bigger valves. My buddy at Tiger Motorsports is the guy that really helped me build this motor. Like I said, I knew nothing about these cars. So this is like first time for everything kind of deal. And honestly, this is the easiest car to work on and to learn. It honestly is. So, you know, it's long tube headers now, built a little intake. I think factory, these motors make like 146 horsepower.
Really?
Yeah. And now it makes 300.
Oh, so you've like doubled the power.
It was like 298 to the wheels, so it rips.
Got it, okay, okay. Is it still the stock suspension that came with the car?
So it's coilovered, lowered, bigger sway bars. You know, I welded up all the mounts for the suspension, like bracing and chassis. That's my off-road side of me, you know?
Yeah.
So like all the mounts for the suspension really ties into the body. It's a unibody car. They're all been beefed up. And then, you know, some strut bracing, front and back, and just, you know, the basic bolt-on stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And shoot, I mean, it's a freaking go-kart. I mean, it honestly, it doesn't go fast enough to outweigh its handling. So it's basically like you're just matted everywhere. You can really drive this car and really learn, you know, aesthetics like cornering and handling and setting the car in.
All right, so let's get into some of the other stuff, because I know there's the like exterior personal touches.
Right.
Obviously, you Linex'd everything.
Yeah,
right?
So there's another part of my truck side,
right,
which I've never seen. This is like a plastic, only the 325 ISs come with this lower valence piece like this.
Yeah.
And I used to get it painted all the time. And anytime I tagged a curb or like went to the canyon and went cruising, it was chipped.
Right.
So I said, you know what, dude, forget this. Like, let's do a bed liner on it. But we did like a finer bed liner, so I didn't want it to look like a bed liner, and coated it. And then I ended up doing the rest of the rubber in the whole car the same thing.
And it's all around like that, right?
Yeah, I eliminated the marker lights. We did that stuff in the back. Not a lot of it, just a little bit of it. And to be honest with you, it has I never clean it. It looks like it's brand new.
Yeah.
You know, I drive the piss out of this car. Don't take rocks off of it. And it looks perfect. So I think I ended up working out perfect for me. I didn't know how it was gonna look. And everyone's always like, wow, I never thought of that.
Nah, it looks really cool. This is totally your touch. Same with
and then I added this little splitter here.
Yeah, is that, did you hand make that?
Yeah, I just cut it and made it with ABS.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then put some, you know, little newer lights in the lower bumper piece.
And this is from your off-road world as well?
Yeah, I had these things laying around. I was like, oh, it'll work. And then I did a roll cage in it. You know, it has some nice wheels.
These are cool.
They're made by ESM. This was like in the 80s, like the factory OZ wheels of the race cars, like Mercedes and BMW. They had like this styro wheel. You know, and that was, so this is kind of like a knockoff of that look.
So you pull the pin, this comes off, and then you get to your lugs?
Yeah, that's just a beauty cover. Yeah. Back in the day, they used to just be one big one, you know?
Right.
So, but that's, like I said, just kind of a fake cover. Keeps it clean. The car got painted.
Right.
So it's not original paint.
Which was it black when you got it?
It was black. So this is an original black on black car.
Okay.
Which was like even harder to kind of get.
So the cage you did in here, is that's, I mean, I know this is one of your specialties, is like you do this for a lot of different companies ask you to build cages for their cars. Mm-hmm. So
I had to build one.
Yeah, well, obviously. But it's, the thing I love about this, and I know you've pointed this out to me before, dude, is how you kept your rear seat, but you go through the rear seat with the cage.
Yeah.
And it's bolted all in, is it welded in, bolted in? Like how does?
So it has like couplers that disconnect it.
Okay.
They like interlock basically.
Okay.
So it's all bolted in the cage because I had it all powder coated. Some people don't really notice this, but like I had it painted this like hammer tone, like 80s hammer tone color. Like this back in the day, 80s, 90s was like, a lot of people did like suspension and stuff like that, old color. So I kind of went with that color scheme. And you know, I moved all the LED lights are wired in the cage. They usually come like on the side here. So I had the headliner gone, got rid of everything in the headliner, so it's just smooth and black, and put all the LEDs in the cage that's wired all through it, comes out the bottom, and it all opens to the door. So it's just like kind of my off-road, you know, because I'm always building this tube chassis stuff.
And so you're taking that and putting it into this car.
A little bit, just to show like, you know, what the difference is between this car and other cars.
Yeah. The other thing you changed for sure is these seats, which I love. I've sat in these. Yeah. I love these seats.
And I want something a little more sporty looking. So I basically, this seat looks just like the Recaro seat, like the stitching, everything, just a little more cradle, but it looks factory.
And, like, and is this still a Recaro or is it?
No,
what's the
brand? A ProScat.
Oh, so that's ProScat, right.
Yeah, and they, like I said, they do a lot of hot rod stuff.
Yeah.
And it like totally fit perfect. And you can see the sides of the door is like, it's dead on. The dash was cracked, so I bought an OEM dash and replaced that entire dash, which was the biggest nightmare of my life.
That like, had to be work.
I work on brand new like trucks, right? And we take apart the entire interior.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, there is more wiring and electronics in that damn dash. And everything is so brittle because it's from the 80s, you know, and 90s. So like everything is like snap, broken, you know? So I think I broke one clip. Swear.
Wow.
So that whole dash been replaced, which anybody knows working on E30s, like that, like you replace the dash in it, like you're like a legend.
You're
so I earned this, you know?
That's
carpet,
crazy,
I mean,
dude.
All the carpet's been redone.
And that's why you keep the dash mat on there now, so.
And I keep it inside.
Yeah.
Because if that thing
never
cracks, I'm selling the car.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's really much it to this car now.
Yeah.
Let's go freaking drive this thing.
Let's go drive it, definitely.
I didn't build this shit for not to go rip it right now and just get into all these turns. The whole point of this car. We'll just get started quick.
God, right away it just feels good.
Sorry, people.
Don't you love that there's no traffic for us?
It's beautiful out too. I mean, you might as well see what we can get it up to right now.
Oh shit. Cooks, dude. Wow, man.
She likes to just be matted.
Right.
Like I was telling you before, once you're doing 100, you're doing 100.
Right.
It doesn't really matter how much power you got.
Right.
You can drive this thing, and we're going to be styling.
And at a certain point up here, you would run out of. It wouldn't matter how much power you have.
No.
You can only go so fast through this turn.
Exactly.
Wow, dude, this car handles great, huh?
For a little 325 IS, it'll get your blood going a little bit.
Yeah, totally. I'm all pumped up right now.
Doesn't have a big old V8 sound and, you know, slaying tires off, but I don't know, man. It gets airborne and it bangs turns real hard.
I'm hoping we don't get air today.
Dude.
Let's not get air, okay? You can tell which one of us is the young punk and which one's the old pussy, right, you guys?
All right, well, let's get after this shit.
God, this car really sticks, doesn't it?
You get the back to like sit and squat into the turn.
Yeah.
And that's when it like really you can rail it. You just gotta get the car to kinda to rotate and just get the back tire to kinda hook. And then from there, it's pretty dialed. You just grip it.
Wow, dude, you're ripping it, man. What tires do you run on this, Steven?
These are Falcons. They're not like crazy. There's a little bit nicer tires out there, but
yeah.
once I get them a little warm, they rock for sure.
This is a blast. This is so fun, dude.
It's crazy. The harder I drive this car, the colder it runs.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, it handles the bumps though, dude.
That's because we're jumping over them.
Oh shit, it's starting to drift a little bit on you.
It'll get a little bit. It's a controlled slide. That's what you want.
No, that's what you want.
I haven't got to really drive this thing this hard yet. It's been a while, so thank you.
Thank you, man.
Puts
I'm sure everybody watching is gonna laugh too when they see the horrified look on my face.
Yeah.
All right, that is it for our shoot of Steven's badass little E30. Yeah, I've been wanting to shoot this one for quite a while. Steven's a really good friend. I mean, he's more like a little brother to me. And he's been working on this, building it, and it's done. It looks great, it drives great, it sounds great. I love all the personal touches that are very, very much Steven's approach to things. And one hell of a ride. That was just a blast ripping through the canyon. So hope you guys had fun in this episode. You gotta know I did. So thanks for hanging and watching and supporting what we do. I really appreciate it, you guys. I will see you in the next episode. All right, man, later.